Hi, my name is Alan Mann. I'm a postdoctoral fellow in the BME department. I also teach classes for the department.
These are human dermal fibroblasts growing in culture. And we're taking phase contrast images to look at their morphology.
So I didn't really understand what an engineer did on like a day-to-day basis until my senior year, where I did a year-long of research with a professor and a grad student. I had my own independent research project. So that's very similar to what you would be doing in your co-op, where you'll go out and actually experience what engineers do on a day-to-day basis. Biomedical engineering is a very broad field. I chose academia, but there's lots of choices you can choose. I had choices of going to industry or working in just general business, but I personally chose academia.
My name is Jay Dolas. I'm a fourth year biomedical engineer. I co-opt at GuidePoint Laboratories in Gainesville, Florida. We didn't really have a specific product. We had a line of different genetic tests that we offered that I would develop that would be performed within the lab. We were looking mainly at diagnosing different types of cancer, such as colorectal, esophageal, and prostate cancer. We're also looking at determining rates of drug metabolism based on genetics. My normal day consisted of research into the different tests that we were doing, the different genes that we were looking at, and then trying to apply my research into developing a test to see what genotype an individual would have, or looking at microRNAs to see and quantifying them to see whether the patient had some sort of disease.
Hi, my name is Nicholas Galevi, and I'm a fourth year biomedical engineering student. I first co-opt in the lab with Dr. Lipisco here at RIT, and then I co-opt most recently at Seahorse Biosciences in North Billerica, Massachusetts. So formerly I was a tech support scientist. I worked with the tech support team at Seahorse Bioscience. My primary job was to collect and catalog information from publications that contained information obtained with the device made by Seahorse Biosciences.
Hi, my name is Amanda Murray. I'm a fourth year biomedical engineering student, and I did my co-op at Stryker Spine. We reported MDRs, which are called medical device reporting, and we would submit these every month to the FDA, and I would work on a daily basis to get complaints that were filed by surgeons and patients through the system. Main problem was really completing FDA requirements, and if they didn't stand up to the specifications that we set, then we needed to recall the product and change the specifications or engineer the device differently so that it followed the specifications.
My name is Dylan. I am a fourth year biomedical engineering student, and I have co-opted three times. First at the lab of Dr. Lipisco at the RIT Department of Biomedical Engineering. Second at the Neural Stem Cell Institute in the Rensselaer area, and thirdly at the SUNY Center for Nanoscale Science and Engineering. At the Neural Stem Cell Institute, actually, I worked with a team of tissue researchers who were trying to develop a cure for certain kinds of degenerative ocular diseases, and they were actually working in a mouse model, which is they were doing research on mice, and one of the big problems that they were having with their research was the difficulty in performing surgical procedures on such a small area because the mouse eye is very small. And I ended up designing a device that helped them to hold the mouse eye in a position that allowed them to conduct their research more quickly and repeatedly, and also made it easier to train new technicians on their procedures. So yeah, I'd say that the overlapping knowledge between the more engineering side of our education and also a lot of biomedical considerations like the anatomy of the eye, you know, what sort of considerations you have to take into account when working with a physiological system. Those were very important because it allowed me to communicate with the tissue researchers and also to do more of a mechanical design.
My name is Caitlin Bussey. I'm a fifth year biomedical engineer, and I've done a year's worth of co-ops now, starting at the Wake Forest Institute for Regenerative Medicine in North Carolina, and then here at RIT in the Nano Biodevices Lab, and then finally at Janssen Pharmaceuticals in Springhouse, Pennsylvania.
I'm Morgan Stessel. I'm a fifth year biomedical engineer as well, and I have co-opted with the Women in Engineering program here at RIT, Janssen Pharmaceuticals in Malvern, PA, and Ortho Clinical Diagnostics in Rochester, New York.
And I worked under the Pharmaceutical Development and Manufacturing Sciences Division under Janssen, and my main project was vaccine development and technology upscale. So I worked a lot with building bioreactors and design of experiments within those bioreactors, primarily with media type and composition. So the cells respond to the different components of the media and will grow differently, experience different growth profiles. So I was trying to find the best one for the media to create the vaccine.
At Ortho Clinical Diagnostics, I did feasibility testing and proof of concept for a new clinical chemistry system. So Ortho Clinical Diagnostics does diagnostic medicine. So blood, urine, and cerebrospinal fluid get tested when the doctor tells that you need a blood test. They grab your blood and then they stick it in a machine. And so Ortho Clinical makes those machines. And so we're working on a new clinical chemistry system.
My name's Kayla Wheeler. I'm a fifth year biomedical engineer, and I've co-opted at strain measurement devices in Connecticut, and also I've co-opted for my startup through the business school. We basically came up with a startup idea of creating headgear to prevent against concussions, particularly in non-helmeted sports. We're working on the customization aspect of the headgear. So we're essentially creating padded foam that we can implement into helmets and also into headbands for non-helmeted sports. And we've had our products, the third party, tested, and basically they perform statistically better than what's already out there, so we were really excited about that.
Hi, my name is Lindsay Dombowski, and I'm a fourth year biomedical engineering student. I've co-opted at Mine Safety Appliances, I've co-opted with Engineering World Health in Rwanda, and I've co-opted at Thermal Gradient. So Thermal Gradient does a point of care device to detect if a patient has HIV or tuberculosis or other diseases using polymerase chain reactions in less than 8 minutes. So the conventional method takes 45 minutes. Real engineering techniques, you really have to think, you really have to come up with your own designs, your own experiments, and use a lot of what I've learned in my classes.
My name's John Ray, and I'm a fourth year biomedical engineering student. I co-opted Santa Fe Pasture in Swiftwater, Pennsylvania. Our problems, more or less being in the flu support lab, was to test different strains of vaccine to see which if we could improve the efficiency of the vaccine made at the end of the process. So we changed small parts of the whole week-long vaccine making process and see what produced the best results.
Cell and molecular biology for engineers was really crucial because that provided me the skills such as DNA extraction and polymerase chain reaction, which were really the fundamentals of the tests that we were doing. Also, engineering analysis gave me data analysis skills, which were useful for just understanding the results I would get from the tests and also trying to optimize the systems.
I really liked biocompatibility and the immune system. That really piqued my interest for my career direction. Also, cell and molecular biology moved me into my first co-op. The fact that I knew how to work under the hood and had that experience was a big factor for them.
Our biocompatibility / immunology class was very beneficial in terms of just understanding the concept behind a vaccine and how it works in the body and how you need to produce it.
My favorite course still is probably the cellular and molecular biology, in which in the lab we get introduced to cell culture, and that has pretty much driven my entire co-op search and my future in general. So
I would say a lot of the lab classes really helped out, being able to explain what projects you're working on, types of equipment such as like LabVIEW and SolidWorks I used in my co-op actually, so those classes are really helpful.
So the goal of the lab was to be able to record the action potential of the worm and from the head to tail and then tail to head, and then using that we were able to find the velocity of the active potential and the conduction.
I'd say this experiment would be relevant because if you wanted to move on to studying action potentials in a human where a prosthetic would be attached to somebody's arm, we would want to be able to map out how action potentials change when you have a different stimulus in a different location.
Nate is going to go ahead and look over to 3.2, and the program will measure the voltage change. Then he'll look back and we'll see what happens. Possibly it could be used to diagnose different types of seizures, whether they're physiological or induced.
We could also use it to measure your reaction time to something. So if someone's having difficulty picking up a light turning color, possibly concussion testing or something like that.
Being a biomedical engineer because I'm really good at math, and the engineering aspect of this biological career path lets me apply that mathematical structure to the biological world.
The thing I like most about being a biomedical engineer is that it's complicated and that it isn't straightforward or it isn't easy in any way. So a lot of the problems that we have to solve are variable or have a lot of variables included in them, and that makes it kind of like a puzzle. And assembling all of the pieces of knowledge that we have from different classes is kind of how you solve that puzzle.
I love being able to use engineering problem-solving skills in a medical or biological application.
Well, I definitely like the biological aspect of both, biomedical science and biomedical engineering, but I feel like the difference comes in the ability to problem-solve. And I like being able to see a process or a system from start to finish and assess where an issue may be, as compared to maybe just understanding an end result and only counting that as true. The broad whole process design that you get to see. With life sciences, you may get to see a process like a cell culture, but you might not completely understand it. As a biomedical engineer, you have the problem solving skills to assess a situation, realize what might be wrong with it, and you can apply that to a life system.
I really like the combination of being able to design products and also help people through those solutions. And I liked being able to have so many applications that are out there, whether it's research or working for an engineering firm, designing prosthetics or medicine.
You have an impact on the fundamentals of what's going on. Doctors, while their work is extremely important, they use what biomedical engineers make.
Learn MATLAB. Use it in every class, actually, probably after your third year. So if you don't know MATLAB, it stacks up pretty quick.
Study, do your homework, I don't know.
Learn physics.
Physics is good.
To make sure that you actually want to be an engineer first, you want to make sure that your math and physics skills are strong so that you can perform as an engineer in essentially any function, but specifically for biomedical applications.
It's so many different things combined. So they need to be interested in the biology component, and they need to be interested in the engineering component. There's a lot of math and biology mixed together.
Make sure that your passion is for helping others, because that's what this major is all about. And I would say, even when it gets difficult, to keep reminding yourself that lives are going to be changed because of the education that you're getting and because of the career path that you're choosing. So it may be difficult now, but you're going to make life easier for someone coming up.
Really branch out and network and make sure that you meet a lot of people and you kind of learn what you're interested in.
Come to RIT, but if you don't want to come to RIT, find a school that has a co-op program, because it's gold. Like, it's worth its weight in gold, literally. You will get a job so quickly. The things you learn in co-op, you can't learn in a traditional academic setting.
I'd say biomedical engineering is obviously a very broad field. You have your range from the mechanical side and the prosthetic development all the way down to maybe the more life sciences and pharmaceuticals and drug delivery. And I'd say a biomedical engineer can cover any aspect of that range.
What we really do is we solve very, very complex problems that require a lot of assumptions, and we have to feel comfortable with them, and we break them down to the simplest forms and we solve them.
To me, I guess, biomedical engineers focus on all the technological advances that are happening today and say, hey, how can we use this to better the lives of people? Not just us in our first world country, but like the entire world. So how can we create a way to fix the future, I guess?
A biomedical engineer combines a lot of different types of engineering into one because the body has so many different types of forces and components to it. So you need to be able to deal with mechanical systems and fluid systems and electrical systems all into one.
If you had a biological researcher, might not have the exposure to engineering concepts that would allow them to solve certain problems, and vice versa. An engineer who could have difficulty providing solutions to somebody who spoke the biospeak, so to say. And if you're a biomedical engineer, you have a foot on both sides of that door, and it allows you to bridge the gap, I'd say, between the two disciplines and allow both of them to work together more effectively to deliver solutions.
I feel like a biomedical engineer utilizes the general engineering principles and skills to solve problems in the medical or biological industries.
Biomedical engineering has a generational impact, and I think that's what biomedical engineers do, is that they change generations to come.